Hello, grade 5. How are you? Today we're going to start lesson 4 in chapter 7. This is called, or this lesson is called War Begins. Okay. Do you know, guys, that in lesson 3, it ends with Britain declared the Intolerable Acts, and after that, the American colonists in America, they wrote a letter to King of Britain about their needs and about their demands, but he refused and didn't answer the letter. Okay, so what happened? Because King George of Britain didn't answer the colonists' letter, so they started to prepare themselves. And here is we have the role of the patriots in America. Okay, who are the patriots? The patriots here is, guys, just 1 minute. Yes, where we are. Okay. Here the patriots, or here in 1775, the many colonists felt sorry and felt very angry about the Intolerable Acts because they were too harsh, okay? And the British Navy blocked the harbor. We know that because of the Intolerable Acts. Okay, what is the role of the patriots? Here the patriots are the colonists who could rebel against the government. So the patriot spoke against the British government and made a great role in this war. Okay, one of the patriots who make actions against the British government is Mercy Otis Warren. Mercy Otis Warren was a woman. She was a writer and she wrote many plays criticizing the British officials in Boston. Okay, so the first patriot, okay, is Mercy Otis Warren. Okay, the next patriot was called Patrick Henry. And Patrick Henry, guys, made speeches made speeches against Britain. And he said that he was eager for a war against Britain. Okay, after that, the colonists started to prepare for them, prepare themselves for a war. And here is, we have the militia. Militia means a group of ordinary people. The normal or the ordinary colonists started to train themselves of how to use weapons, how to use guns, preparing themselves for a battle against Britain. Okay. And most of those men, by the way, were farmers. Most of the militia were farmers. Okay, what happened? Here we have the battles they held against the British government. So here is, guys, we have Paul Revere Ride. Paul Revere, by the way, is also a patriot. And here is, we're going to read about his role in the battles against the Britain. So the British leaders were worried about the militias when the colonists in America started to prepare themselves, and those militias started to train themselves how to use the weapons. Now the British leaders, okay, they were worried about having weapons and having gunpowder. So General Thomas Gage, and don't forget this person, General Thomas Gage. He is the British governor of Massachusetts. So he was from Britain. He is the British governor of Massachusetts. Okay, he has orders from the British or the country of British, okay, to stop any rebellion against the Britain. Also, he learned that the British were, he also learned that the Patriots were storing the gunpowder and cannons in Concord. Okay, so don't forget, because we have Concord battle. Now, he knew that those Patriots store the gunpowder, the weapons, and the cannon in Concord. Okay, and Concord blazed 2 miles from Boston. What did Gage do? Gage decided to send some soldiers to destroy all the stores that include all the gunpowder and the cannons. The soldiers would march at night to take the Patriots by surprise. So they want to attack at night to surprise the militia or to surprise the Patriots. And General Gage couldn't, you know, couldn't keep his plan secret. So those militia and patriots in Boston knew about what he was planning. So they used the lantern. Lanterns, it means something like lamps, okay, in the Tower of Boston to face the British soldiers who were coming. Here is come the role of Paul Revere. So two patriots rode their horses to warn the militia that the British soldiers are coming to destroy the stores of weapons and cannons. Okay, who were these two patriots? Paul Revere and William Dowse. Paul Revere and William Dowse. They rode their horses at night and went to warn the militia that the British soldiers are coming to destroy the store of weapons and cannons. Okay, so Revere and Dowse moved ahead, alerting the sleeping Minutemen. Also, we have a new term of Minutemen. Minutemen are militia, by the way, but with a special training. Okay, so Minutemen are militia, but with a special training. Okay, so the Minutemen were ready to fight or to battle those British soldiers. Racing through night, Revere told the Minutemen that the regulars, means the British soldiers, are coming out, okay? And those regulars, don't forget, it's a word used to express or about the British soldiers. Okay. The British soldiers had caught one of them, and then he left free after the other. So they captured Paul Revere, but after that, they released him. Okay, so the first battle. Here is we speak about, or the main idea of this section speaks about that colonists and the British soldiers fought two battles in Massachusetts. What are these battles? The Battle of Lexington and Concord. You know, Concord is the place where the colonists store their weapons and cannons. So the British soldiers reached Lexington before sunrise on April 19, and the Minutemen were waiting there. British soldiers, a British soldier told the Minutemen to leave, but the Minutemen didn't lift, and one of the two groups fired a shot. Nobody who fired the shot, the British soldiers or the Minutemen, no one know. But after this shot, both sides start or began shooting over each other, okay? When they stopped shooting, eight colonists were dead and nine were wounded, and only one British soldier was hurt. Okay, the British soldiers marched on to Concord to destroy the store, but when the British soldiers searched Concord for hidden weapons, more Minutemen gathered nearby the store, and also they start shooting fires, okay? The Minutemen forced the British to turn back toward the Boston. And after that, the British soldiers were in dangerous situation on the way back, because now who is getting stepped? Are the colonists. But now the British soldiers are in the back line. Okay, so they stepped back. And the patriots and the Minutemen from the town between Concord and Boston, as well as the town farther north and south, were ready. As the British marched back to Boston, the colonists shot at them. From behind the trees and the stone walls, they start shooting at the British soldiers. And in this battle, around 250 British soldiers were wounded or killed, by the way, okay? After that, the Battle of Lexington and Concord, the news about the Battle of Lexington and Concord spread quickly. And more militia and more people gathered and included in the armed colonists surrounded the city. The British in Boston, of course, feel the trap, okay, that the number of the Minutemen and the militia is increasing, okay, while they are fighting. After the Patriot militia surrounded Boston, they had time to plan. So the militia leaders think or thought of building a fort, okay, on Bunker Hill. Where is Bunker Hill? Bunker Hill is a place across Charles River from Boston, and from there they will build their fort and build their fort and start to fire shots or fire cannons from there, okay, of course, at the British soldiers in Boston. When the militia arrived the Bunker Hill, they chose to build their fort on Breed Hill instead, okay? But it was closer to Boston, so they named it Bunker Hill Battle, but it was in Breed Hill region. But this information is not important, by the way. They worked through night to build the fort, okay? And after they built the fort, they found themselves that they ran out of guns, okay? So when the British were close enough, the militia in the fort began shooting, but many soldiers fell and the British were forced back. Minutes later, the British attacked again and were hunted and were turned back. The third time the British attacked, the Patriots ran out of gunpowder. Lock in this time in Bunker Hill, battle, what happened? The Minutemen and all the Patriots, they all ran out of gunpowder. And finally, the British captured the fort, but in this battle, the militia and the Patriots and the Americans in general, they recognized that they could fight well, but they need more training and more weapons. Okay. A colonial army. Here is after these three battles, the colonists started to think of making a strong army for America, okay? And they called this army the First Continental Army, okay? So here is remembered that the First Continental Congress has sent their demands to the British colonists, but when the British colonists refused, they gathered and they had these battles, Lexington, Concord, and Bunker Hill, okay? So they gathered again, the representative of the Congress, they gathered again to make a meeting. This meeting is called the Second Continental Congress. And here is the delegates. Delegates means the representative. Knew that soon they would have a war with Britain. So they needed more than trained militia to win the war against the Britain. They need an army. They didn't need ordinary people that can carry weapons. No, they need a trained army, okay? Because soldiers in any army, guys, they fight until a war is over, not fight in just a battle. So now the Congress decided to create or to build a new army, and they will call or they would call this army the Continental Army. Okay, who will be the commander of this army? Commander means the leader. When I say commander means the officer in charge of an army. The commander will be George Washington. Okay, so here is George Washington. You know that he is a skillful officer that made a great effort in the French Indian War, and he will be the commander of the Continental Army or of the American Army. Okay, many delegates to the Second Continental Congress didn't want a war, by the way, with Britain, because they know that Britain is a very strong and powerful country. They only wanted to Britain to look at their demands to stop taxing them, to take the English soldiers go back to Britain and stop taxing them. That's it. That's what. Oh, and to have also representatives in the British in the British Parliament. By the way, that's all their needs. Okay, so the Congress decided to make only one try before the war against Britain. So in July 1775, the delegates sent King George III the olive branch petition. Petition is something like a letter or something like a written request. Okay, this olive branch is a symbol of peace. They need peace first before a war. They need to stop taxes. They need to have representatives in the British Parliament, and also they need the British soldiers to go back to Britain. Okay, but what about King George? When he read this petition, he refused all these demands, and he started to send more soldiers to the colonists. Okay, and here is, guys, what happened after King George refused their demands and the last try to achieve peace before the war. For the next 9 months, the British Army stayed in Boston, and Washington spent the time turning the colonial militia into a real army. He started to train those people, and he also sent a trusted officer. This officer is named Henry Knox. Henry Knox, he sent it to New York, and the Americans had captured the fort and its cannons earlier that year. Okay, but this part is not important. Knox and his soldiers dragged the cannons to Boston, so he took all the cannons and gunpowder and all of that stuff. When cannons arrived, the British decided to leave Boston. And on March 1776, they sailed out of Boston Harbor. Forcing the British to leave Boston was a success, of course, for the Patriots, but the war was just the beginning, okay? So in that time when they knew that Knox took all the cannons to Boston, okay? Oh, I'm sorry, out of Boston. So the soldiers started to leave the Boston Harbor, and this is considered as a success for the colonists in America, and especially for the Patriots and for the American militia, okay? This was our lesson today, guys, how the war started by the three battles of Lexington, Concord, and Bunker Hill. Okay, watch the video again, and if you need any question about this section, contact me anytime. Thank you, grade five, and goodbye.